In this packet, we will look at problems involving related rates. Here's the layout for approaching these types of problems. First example, I already started this problem by drawing a diagram so I can get a nice picture of what's going on. So here I read the problem again and make note of key information that I may use to solve the problem. Now let's finish the diagram now that we have more information. Oil spills out into the water. It spreads out in a circle. And what this means is we have an area of oil that is getting bigger over time. What also happens is the radius of the circle the oil is making over time increases as well. So area of a circle is a function of time, and so is the radius of the circle. Now we have a better picture of what's going on. Now we can start to solve this problem. Recall the area of a circle. A equals pi r squared. Also remember a and r are both functions of t. Now we can use some of the key information we highlighted from reading the problem. One key piece is the radius increases at 30 meters per hour, which we write as dr dt equals 30 meters per hour. And we want to know how fast the area is increasing when the radius is 100 meters, which we write as dA dt equals question mark. Now we take the derivative of the whole equation implicitly with respect to t. And now we plug our known information in, and done. Next example. Like the previous example, we start by reading the problem, highlighting key information, and then drawing a diagram. Now we continue to draw important parts of the diagram to get a better idea on how to solve this problem. The balloon is a sphere, and as air gets pumped in, the volume increases as well as the radius of the balloon. Both volume and radius can be written as functions of time. Now that we have a good idea of the picture, we recall the volume of a sphere. At this point, we can write some of our key information down, like volume increases at rate dV/dt of 5 cubic centimeters per minute. We want to find rate of radius increasing, dr dt, when diameter is 20 centimeters. Now we take the derivative of the equation implicitly with respect to t. So here we have our related rate equation. We now can plug in dv dt and r equals 10 centimeters, then solve for dr dt. And bam, done. A cone tank example now. Let's read the problem and identify key information. Now we add to the diagram to get a better picture of what's going on. Let's draw a line from bottom to the top, and also make note that the base radius is 5 feet. Note the right triangle formed by doing this. Also make note that the height of the tank is 14 feet. Poke a hole in the bottom of the tank to see that water is leaking out. So what we see here is that the volume of the water is decreasing at a rate of 2 cubic feet per hour. Also, the depth of water is decreasing at a certain rate as well. The radius is also decreasing as water leaks out. Let's write these as functions of t. Now we recall the volume of a cone. Let's write down the key information we highlighted. Now we revisit the right triangle that we formed when adding to our diagram earlier. And we recall similar triangles, since as the volume is decreasing, the triangle gets smaller as well. We can actually solve for both h and r, so let's do it since we may need them both later. Since we want dh dt, it makes sense to substitute r into our volume equation. Now we take the derivative implicitly with respect to t. Now we go back to some key information. Volume of water is leaking out at a rate of dBdt of 2 cubic feet per hour. Plug that into our equation and solve for dH dt, which is of course the rate that the depth is decreasing. Notice that the sign is negative here. This makes sense because as time goes on, the depth decreases. For part B, we want to find the rate that the radius is decreasing as the water leaks out. So now, we go back to our previous work, and remember that we solved for H with similar triangles too. So we can plug that in and get the equation in terms of V and R. Now we plug in dV dt equals negative 2 cubic feet per hour and solve for dr dt. Again, it makes sense for the sign to be negative, since the radius is decreasing as time goes on. Related rates are so much fun, right?